Okay. I think everything is working. So let's try again. I recorded this recently, to be honest, when still I had my old laptop. But now I have my new PC and I wanted to record it again. Also, I love Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, and I was thinking recording this before the Hellblade: Senua's Saga, which is the second part, like comes out in May. So yeah, I'm probably not gonna comment too much about the game. Yeah, but welcome in to watch this series of Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. I remember quite okay-ish the story, but I'm gonna try to go through all of it. And yeah, I'm playing on keyboard and mouse, so I'm sorry if you can hear the clickety-clack. But yeah, it's impossible to get rid of, like, totally. Yeah. Let's go.
Deep into darkness. There'll be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
Watching.
Why doesn't she come back? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I feel you coming.
Shh. Quiet. Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? Been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look around you. Can you see them over there?
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
Look. Up ahead. You see it too.
You promised you gave me.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Stop. Can you
watching her. I'm watching her.
You're so close to the darkness.
Go back.
Can you feel it?
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it, turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. So much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
We are gonna call. Yes. Thank you. So normally these runes would be red, so you would know like which runes you are gonna collect during the game. And it starts from the top, yeah. And between always the dots, there is like how many runes you can find from the specific location. But yeah, let's go to enjoy actually the story.
My story, Senua, because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the River of Knives that flows from the dark world of Niflheim.
I really can't
was right. What was it he said? The river of knives across which lies the halls of hell. The place they call Helheim.
Northmen speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
What are the... Oh, F. I love how the whispers are like saying go back and you can do it, because like that's like something he wants a lot of with like simpler mental health issues people struggle also like this is it.
Don't kill me. I'm not one of them.
Don't just
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way. Again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth?
Is that you?
How do you know?
From my tales of the Northmen, they call me Truth. A liar.
He's lost.
An old fool. Truth is my truth.
Good to see you again. You kept your vow.
Guide you in this life and the next. will tell you my stories of hell, if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
Why aren't you looking at us? Take a closer look.
It's near. Look towards the gate, and the gate will open.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
No, no,
it worked.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell, but I watched the Northmen, learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened when everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. They weren't real. But what good is that when we are always here?
So yeah, what I was earlier saying, like mental health and hound walking, and like of course in psychosis I have no knowledge about like how it works, because haven't read into it. But the thing is, like, even you can, like, relate to, like, that part of the game, but I feel like a lot of people can relate to the struggles what Senua go through during the game, which was the part for me which made it, like, really important. I think it's on the other side. Never would walk on these.
You can stand on the edge. Pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near. Waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
I hate heights. And this game has them.
Is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed. And with her, you must bargain.
I love this game in every way. Like, the story is, like, amazing. The audio world, loving. Yeah. So here we are, playing this probably 5th time already.
Kate.
but I'm happy to share this story with you all. Where's my mouse?
It's nearly over.
That went with a little a struggle. I remember correctly, you have to lose this fight in the beginning. Because we cannot do anything yet to these two dudes, but firing these guys is too much fun. Oh, damn it.
Her suffering will have been for nothing.
It's just a matter of time.
The dark rot will grow each time you fade. As the rot reaches Senua's head, the worst is... I still haven't figured it out. I'm probably, after this playthrough, I'm gonna figure out like how much it takes to actually fail.
The heartless battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost. Two gods first.
Two gods?
Two gates.
Which one did she choose first?
One of them will kill her, I know.
She's going to die.
Uh-oh. Which one will she
The Northmen say that in the beginning, there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born, and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow, whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that.
And there, I think, could be the first episode. Hellblade Senua's sacrifice. And yeah. We will see in the next one, and we are gonna then go to fight maybe Valravn, I think. Yeah. Till the next time. Bye!